Have you ever wondered who processed the water so it is clean to drink? Have you ever wondered who designed an efficient transport system to facilitate your journey daily? Have you also wondered who built all these safe structures for our living? It's all by civil engineers. We are civil engineers who embrace emerging technologies such as artificial intelligence to build a smarter and more sustainable built environment that is more adaptive to the negative impact of future climate change. Hello, I'm Anthony, Associate Professor and UG Coordinator of the Department of Civil and Environmental Engineering at HKUST. In this talk, I'll introduce you what civil engineering is, some examples of exciting civil engineering works in Hong Kong, and our programs at HKUST.
So, what is civil engineering? It is an engineering discipline that deals with the built environment, which encompasses much of what defines modern civilization we see nowadays. Civil engineers are the professors who built safe structures such as buildings, bridges, roads, tunnels, and many other types of infrastructure. In short, we engineer a civilized environment for the mankind. Different from architects who mainly involve in the pre-construction phase of infrastructure, civil engineers apply science and mathematics to design the infrastructure and oversee the entire design to completion process. We make sure the design is structurally feasible and optimal, and we make the design into reality. Civil engineering covers a broad range of disciplines which engineers would need to tackle different kinds of construction challenges. Broadly speaking, we can categorize civil engineering into six disciplines. The first one is structural and material engineering. The discipline focuses primarily on the design and analysis of structures that can withstand external forces. Structural engineers are trained to design buildings or bridges following statutory provisions and ensure that they are safe and suitable for a specific usage. For example, we have many tall, slender buildings in Hong Kong. We need to carefully consider wind load and conduct simulations to assess the structural performance of the buildings. Another discipline is geotechnical engineering. Geotechnical engineers deal with soil and rock and their influences on the safety of buried infrastructure, such as piles and tunnels. For mountainous regions like Hong Kong, these engineers play a crucial role in assessing landslide risk under rainfall and designing effective systems such as barriers and retaining walls to reduce the damage to the cities. Environmental engineering covers aspects related to quality improvement for water and land, monitoring and modeling of air pollution and environmental threats associated with our ever-changing climate. Environmental engineers develop low-carbon and sustainable solutions for improving and protecting our natural environment. Water resource engineering is crucial to coastal cities like Hong Kong. If you still remember, in 2023, we had several very strong tropical cyclones, Saola and Haikui. The storm events had seriously flooded Macau, but not Hong Kong. It is the achievement of our civil engineers who had constructed effective urban drainage systems and catchment of rainwater to prevent the city from damage and property loss due to flooding. Civil engineers also design transportation networks and systems. We do not build high-speed trains nor the cars, but plan and manage transport infrastructure that these vehicles travel on. For example, how can we direct the traffic from one tunnel to another one in the most efficient and fair way? This is an example of the problems that we try to solve. For big projects like airport and major bridges, we have hundreds or thousands of people working on construction sites. They have different names, skill sets, and tasks. System engineering studies the management of these manpower, finance, resources, etc. in infrastructural projects. Advanced digital technologies like beam building information modeling and sensing technologies are adopted to aid civil engineers' design and planning. Nowadays, we often hear a term called smart cities. A city cannot have no buildings, no roads. Civil engineering is fundamental to developing a smart city. We are now living in a digital era. Civil engineers develop and adopt cutting-edge digital technologies and artificial intelligence in construction. making our buildings and bridges smarter and also making our environments greener, more resilient, comfortable, and livable. One example of smart civil engineering is technology-based smart construction. Every job site serves as a data source for AI, generating insights from mobile images, drone videos, and security sensors. This enables analysis through AI and machine learning, allowing managers to monitor worker activities by analyzing site video, enhancing safety and decision-making. Here is another example of smart civil engineering. We utilize innovative technologies such as drones, artificial intelligence, and robotics to transform infrastructure maintenance through data-driven automation, including real-time concrete crack detection. The globe is facing grand challenges in terms of sustainability. Civil engineering plays an important role to the 17 Sustainable Development Goals set by the United Nations, including clean water and sanitation, clean energy, innovation and infrastructure, sustainable cities, and climate action. Civil engineers seek and provide solutions to mitigate natural hazards under the negative impact of climate change. With emerging technologies in recent decades, can we make better prediction of our climate? Can we develop smarter hazard warning systems? Can we make the engineering design more automated? And can we enhance the efficiency of construction? Yes, artificial intelligence is an excellent tool to make civil engineering design much smarter and sustainable. On August 2023, under the leadership by the Department of Civil Engineering, HKUST has launched the first satellite for advancing our capabilities on environmental research related to climate change. With the launch of the HKUST FYBB1 satellite, we are able to collect enormous amount of climate data. Together with the use of machine learning and AI technologies, we can now make better forecasting of typhoon, providing necessary data to civil engineers to devise accurate mitigation plans to prevent damages from natural hazards. In addition to improving our ability to make more accurate climate prediction, the satellite is extremely useful for geotechnical engineers to make informed decisions on slope management at regional scale. Our department has been working closely with the related departments of the Hong Kong government to transfer the new technologies to real-life application. Another application of AI in civil engineering is the creation of integrated human-robot AI collaboration relationship, aiming to make the construction industry more efficient and safe. The robot can be trained to operate repetitive site activities. After knowing some general backgrounds of civil and environmental engineering, let's take a look at what exciting civil engineering development we have in Hong Kong and our neighboring regions. This is a future map on how Hong Kong will look like in 2030 and beyond. The government has a long-term vision of strategic urban development plans, such as Lantau Tomorrow and the North Metropolis Development Strategy. Civil engineering industry will be boosting in the next 20 to 30 years. This is a forecast made by the Construction Industry Council in 2023. The figure shows a clear increasing number of government investment and construction activities in the future of Hong Kong, meaning an increasing demand of workforce in the next 10 years. This is a list of 10 major infrastructural projects in Hong Kong. Some have been completed, such as the number 1 South Island Line. That's where the MTR station at Ocean Park was created. We have also completed the Express Rail Link and Hong Kong-Zhuhai-Macau Bridge in 2018. There are many exciting ongoing projects such as Kai Tak Area. New urban developments like Lok Ma Chau and Hung Shui Q areas are still far from completion. We have a lot more interesting projects to work on in the future. How many of you have been to the Hong Kong-Zhuhai-Macau Bridge? It is one of the biggest projects for Hong Kong, greatly reducing your travel time between Hong Kong, Macau, and Zhuhai. With our solid civil engineering work, the bridge has survived the historical typhoon Mangkhut in 2018. If you have a chance to pay a visit, I'm sure you will be amazed by what civil engineers have built. The Kai Tak development area where our old airport was situated at together with the Kwantung and Kowloon Bay districts, will provide 5.4 million square meters of office space and is positioned as the second central business district in Hong Kong. It will also provide many residential flats. This development plan means that there will be a lot of buildings to be designed and constructed for the project in recent years. Some quick information about rankings. This year, HKUST is ranked 47th in the world, and our civil and environmental engineering program is ranked top 27 globally. So our civil engineering programs at HKUST, both teaching and research, is world-leading. Now let's talk about what our civil and environmental engineering program at HKUST will offer to prepare our students to have a solid foundation in the many disciplines of civil engineering. We have two programs, civil engineering and civil and environmental engineering. Both programs have met the requirements of the four divisions of the Hong Kong Institution of Engineers, which are civil, structural, geotechnical, and logistics and transportation engineering. This means that our graduates are eligible to take part in the so-called Scheme A training leading to a chartership and becoming a professional civil engineer. This provides a faster pathway than those who study civil engineering programs from some overseas countries. Both CIVL and CIEV programs are designed for a four-year study. The first year will cover general engineering knowledge, and students will learn some fundamentals of civil engineering since the second year. The third year will start to cover some special courses in different disciplines. The program covers totally 120 credits for graduation. Our department also offers a minor program in Smart City, which is an emerging topic, both locally and internationally, and is highly relevant and important in the future of the civil engineering industry. We will provide multidisciplinary training and knowledge needed for building smart cities that are green, resilient, empowering, adaptable, and transformative. We are now living in a digital era. Developing foundations on data analytics and being able to apply state-of-the-art artificial intelligence in civil engineering is crucially important to address the future challenges of dealing with more complex engineering systems. We offer an extended major in AI program. Students in either CIVL or CIEV in this extended major will be exposed to various computer science courses, effectively developing concepts, skill sets, and hands-on experiences in the applications of AI in civil engineering. What is special and attractive about our program is that we require students to gain hands-on experiences by applying what has been learned from the classroom. This includes industrial training, internship, final year project, and capstone design projects. These trainings will make our students more marketable for future job hunting. This is the professional path how our graduates would become chartered engineer after graduation. If you are admitted to our program at HKUST next year in 2025, you will graduate in 2029 and can start the four-year HKIE Scheme A training. After 4 years, you can be a professional engineer chartered under HKIE. Afterwards, you can be further promoted to senior engineer, chief engineer, or even partner and director of different engineering firms. Most of our graduates will join the consultant, contractor, and client sectors, which represent three major different roles in civil engineering industry. Salary. This figure is only for reference. There are fluctuations in the salary range, but overall it is attractive and we are one of the engineering programs whose graduates earn the highest salary. Not surprising, because of the boosting industry and increasing demand of workforce. Civil engineering is a global profession. Our alumni have been involved in various exciting projects. For example, Kelvin Chan, who is a graduate in 2016 and currently a resident engineer working for a consultant company, has been participated in multiple mega projects, including the design and construction of Siung Kwan O, Lam Tin Tunnel, Cross Bay Link, Yuen Long South Development.
Civil engineering is an exciting profession and a boosting industry in the next 20 to 30 years. There are many interesting yet challenging opportunities waiting for you. If you are ready to help build our society, and if you are ready to embrace emerging technologies to make our built environment smarter, more sustainable, and more efficient, join our big family. If you want to know more about our programs, or if you have any further questions, please feel free to contact us. Civil engineering is not just about the things we build, it is also about the people. People with deep technical understanding and analytical skills. People who are creative and able to communicate those ideas clearly. People who can lead and work together. We train leaders who will engineer a more civilized, smarter, and sustainable environment for mankind. We hope you will join us to help build a future. Yours and ours.